TUCat. Dang. TUCat. Are you helping?
It's held for kind of a long time. I kind of want to get a picture of it.
Yeah, it's time to run to the UPS store. I've got a lot of packages to return.
TUVlog Cat's bumping into stuff again this morning. I don't know what his problem is. Actually, it's not the morning anymore. It's the afternoon. Again, got tied up doing some stuff this morning. Went out, ran a few errands, came back, missed UPS. So now I have to wait till tomorrow to get the other camera that I ordered. TUCat is all about it. I think he's upset he wasn't part of the intro last time.
TUCat, TUCat. Welcome everybody to the vlog. You're not being very exciting for the intro here, Cat.
All right, time to grab these packages and get out the door. All right, well, this should be a familiar sight. Welcome to TUVlog 24? TUVlog 24, I believe. Backing out of the old neighborhood here. You know, I got my grass cut like 2 days ago. Boxes are going everywhere back there. And there's already a dandelion. Like a big one. It certainly does not feel like it's almost October. It just, I can't believe how quick the summer went by, and it doesn't feel like the summer's over because it's still hot. Like, it's not just warm, it's hot today. So, yeah. Anyway, this should be a pretty quick little journey. Just heading off to the UPS store to drop off some packages. And that's pretty much it. Not a whole lot else to do. Got my other shopping and stuff done this morning. I wasn't gone for very long at all, and got back and missed UPS. So go figure, I hit it in that small little window. Usually the UPS guy doesn't come around until 4:30 in my neighborhood, but he must have came really early today at like 1 o'clock. So that's unusual. In other dramatic news, there was a break-in in the neighborhood overnight into cars. So anybody that had their car parked outside and left it unlocked, they got their car gone. They went through the car, stole stuff. I think someone got their debit card stolen. I think the camera's moving. So yeah, not good. Whoa, we're sliding. But yeah, so that's not good. Thankfully I park in a garage, but still just knowing that people are starting to go through the neighborhood I live in and do stuff like that, it's not cool. We've had a rise in crime, unfortunately, for the last few years in my neighborhood. And it's really a shame because it's a nice community out here, and just a lot of unfortunate things have been happening lately with gas station robberies and break-ins in neighborhoods, and there was a house break-in, and yeah, sign of the times, I guess. But other than that, it's a beautiful sunny day outside. Like I said, pretty hot, but other than that, you know, really no complaints here. I don't think we're supposed to have rain again for a while. To like next week, and it's not supposed to cool off until right around my birthday, which is like early October. So this reminds me back when I used to be in school and it would still be really hot, and the classrooms didn't really have adequate air conditioning, which was always an issue. The schools just weren't designed back then to really handle like really high temperatures, because it wasn't this thing where you went back to school like the end of July like it is now. I mean, it was like September to like May or so. So that we were never really in school during the height of the heat of the summer. But every now and then the heat would stay and we would get out of school just because it got too hot. But that was rare. I just remember sitting in the classroom sweating. But oh, now all the schools have, well, not all the schools, majority of the schools have that taken care of. It's not like I was in a bad school district either. It was just back then they didn't have air conditioning in all the schools. Or if they did, it wasn't great air conditioning. I'm trying to remember if they were window air conditioner units or what they were. I don't really recall, you know, a huge amount of detail from that time. Obviously, I was young, but I do remember getting off school if it was really, really hot. I think it used to happen in the spring, too. Anywho, pure excitement, right? TUVlog 23 should be going up today. It's uploaded, it's processed, it's ready to go. I think I'm gonna do it around 5 o'clock. And yeah, I'm almost to the UPS store, so I'm gonna go drop off my package and get started with the rest of my day. All right, successful outing dropping off the packages. Ooh, look at that sun. Look at that. That is bright. Man, it's bright out here. Beautiful day, though. Really beautiful day. That's better. Nice and cool in the house. I always have the air conditioning running pretty high overnight because I don't like to get at all, even the smallest bit, sweaty when I'm sleeping. So I kind of crank the air conditioning at nighttime because why not? I don't want to be sweaty. I can't sleep if I'm hot. So I actually let it get hotter in here during the day and then crank the air at night. But that's just me. Dang, TUCat. Looking kind of rough, buddy. Getting old, man. All right, so got some natural light coming in now. Hopefully that's helping things a little bit here. I always like the natural light. We're getting to the time of year where there's gonna be less and less of it, so try to take advantage of it while I can. Let's see here. Anything exciting on Twitter today? I feel like today's kind of a slow news day as far as things happening. Well, my SIM card's here for Ting, but my phone's not, so I can't do a whole lot with that SIM card. I also have a case coming from NZXT. That sounds pretty interesting. I can talk about it right now because I won't be posting this vlog until the day the embargo lifts, the 27th. So I can say things, but what was the email about it? I'm still not entirely sure what I'm even getting from them, but it says, keep this information under embargo until September 27th. The fun part, we have a case coming and it's very VR friendly. So I don't know what that means. Does that mean it's like water cooling friendly? Does that mean it's like a backpack? What does that mean? Whatever it is, it's gonna be here tomorrow, so mystery will be solved at that point. But I am curious. I'm very curious what this is gonna be. So yeah, that's gonna be interesting. I have no idea what that means. They sent another email about LED fans, so I'm curious what those are. Two separate things. I was thinking, I don't know. I'm getting stuff confused now. Because this was a press release issued on September 13th, so this was last week. The AER RGB line of LED PWM fans. I don't know, they're not cheap. A 3-pack of the bad boys is $90, so. and I don't know if that includes the controller? Okay, it was Hue lighting. I think in the other vlog, I couldn't figure out if it was Hue or Q. Users can control up to 5 RGB fans using the Hue Plus lighting channel. Up to a maximum of 10 fans. NZXT is doing some stuff right now. That's basically what that comes down to. But a lot of stuff should be coming tomorrow. I should be getting the camera, the Sony camera. I should be getting that case from NZXT. I should be getting my phone for my Ting account. So tomorrow should be a pretty unboxing full day. Unboxful? It's an unboxful day tomorrow. I'm making up that word now. It's official. It's mine. What else? I'm not gonna lie, I had pizza last night. I did. I had pizza, and to be fair, I put grilled chicken on it, though. Does that count at all for anything? Probably not. But I'm gonna have some of that for lunch, too. I had leftovers. Because that's the beauty of pizza. You can get about 3 meals out of it. Hair's getting a little long. I think it's about time for a haircut. As a matter of fact, I'm pretty sure I might have a haircut within, like, the next week. Look at this table. My God, I need to get a new table. How many times have I said that in a vlog at this point? I need to get a new table. What else? There's stuff everywhere. I've got boxes of, I mean, so much stuff. There's just stuff everywhere. The Corsair box, the power supply box, the ribbon cable box. There's just stuff. And I need to get organized. So within the next couple of weeks, I'm gonna get a dumpster and start cleaning out just old stuff that's been just sitting, like back in the other room and everything else. One of the things I was kind of contemplating doing was maybe like bringing back an old build. So I'm not sure. I might do that because I've still got the original Core i7 and the motherboard and all that good stuff. I might actually rebuild that, benchmark it, and kind of see where it lands today in comparison to what's out there. Because I really don't want to get rid of that. Like, that's kind of a special moment for me. That's when I kind of really turned from just like kind of, not really casual builds. I never really had anything like super like nice until that point as far as computers go. And at that time, having a Core i7 like 920, even though it was the entry level i7, it was like a big deal. At least it was to me. And I just don't want to get rid of that. That was like a good build. I ran for a long time. My dad had it. But there's a lot of other stuff in there that's just old. There's like damaged cases. I mean, there's fans sitting in front of me right now, like these fans. Like, I keep hoarding fans thinking I'm gonna do something with them. I'm never going to use these fans in anything. They're loud, super loud. I would never recommend somebody use these fans in anything because there's just a lot better options out there. So I couldn't tell you how many fans like this I have that have been on things I've purchased that I've removed. Case fans, I have a ton of case fans that were just loud. And a lot of them I think are Cooler Master fans, but yeah, the only case fans I've ever found that tend to be okay, like stock, have been Fractal and some NZXT cases. It's weird. They always look like the same fans, and sometimes they're quiet, sometimes they're loud. I don't know. I usually give the case fans a shot. I give them a fair shake when I go to do a build, and then if they're loud, then I yank them out. But if they're okay, I leave them in. Ooh, I just got a text. Did I get a text? No. Junk mail tweets. So last night, I was uploading TUVlog 23 because it takes a long time to upload the TUVlogs. They're big files, like 9 gigabytes, if not more. So I'm uploading it to YouTube. It's like an hour and a half upload time, sometimes 2, depending on how my connection's going. And Bright House has been doing service outages between midnight and like 6 a.m. on a fairly regular basis. And it's really an issue because that's when I do the upload, because I like to get the file uploaded and then go to sleep, because it takes so long for YouTube to process files that are that big, which, you know, is understandable, that I like to just let it do it overnight. That way when I get up in the morning, the file is processed and it's processed in full HD. So I had it uploading, it was almost done, and then Bright House does their maintenance window again, kills the upload. So then I got to start all over again. So I ended up being up really late last night because I don't like to go to sleep until the upload's complete and it moves into processing for that exact reason, because it was almost uploaded. Had I gone to bed, I would have woken up this morning and had a file it didn't complete. So really frustrating. And I called Bright House because what happened is Spectrum purchased Bright House Networks. So Bright House is now Spectrum, and they're in this whole 2-year transition period. Their service has really gotten crappy since this has happened. And they'll deny it all day long. No changes happening for a couple of years, blah, blah, blah. Well, that's crap, okay? When a company acquires another company, they start making changes right away, and then they lie about it. And that's exactly what's happening with Bright House, because my parents switched over to having them for their phone, internet, and cable TV, and their phone has gone out within the first month or so, I don't know how many times, and just stopped working. They've had a technician at their house. I can't even tell you how many times they've had a technician at their house. It's ridiculous. I think my mom has made something crazy. It's like 15 or 30 or some crazy amount of calls to Bright House. So their phone goes down all the time. Their cable keeps going out on and off now, which it wasn't doing for a long time. Their boxes like is kind of wonky. Like the settings keep changing. That's all kinds of stuff happening. Their internet was messed up. They had to come in and redo that twice. The internet goes out all the time. They're telling them they need to unplug and plug in their modem on like a regular basis. Never had these issues. For years and years and years of being on Bright House, I never had these issues, and now I'm starting to have issues. My connection's slowing down. I'm not getting the full 90 megabits that I'm paying for. I think there might be some throttling going on from what I can tell, because the speeds are just dropping way down. TUCat is up. But it's unfortunate to see a company that I love. I mean, I used to preach Bright House Networks to people all the time because their customer service was great, their actual service, their internet service was fantastic, and now I'm just having issues. It's like I can't walk away from an upload without making sure that it uploads because I don't trust it anymore, and that's a bummer. So that's my rant, but yeah, unfortunate. You know, my bank, for example, I banked at like a small town bank, and they got purchased, and immediately. First off, they laid off all the people that worked for the bank, so all those people lost their jobs. And then the bank that I went to, obviously, because they laid everybody off, shut down, so I had to start going to the bank that, you know, the company's bank that purchased the other company. So now everybody's confused because my checks say one thing, but it's another bank. It's a whole thing. Their customer service is awful. Their bill payment system's terrible. They don't pay bills when they're supposed to. When you go in there, I used to be able to walk into the bank and they would say, "Hi, Chris," and I could give him a check, and I didn't have to do anything. I didn't have to give him an account number. I didn't have to show my ID. I didn't have to do anything. They knew who I was. They, you know, would say hello when I walked in. I'd give them a check. They'd put it in my account. No questions asked. Half the time I go in there, they'd give you, like, ice cream. They had really nice coffee. It was great. Now you walk in there, and you're just a number, just like banking at Chase or anything else. So it sucks. I'm not a fan of big companies buying small companies at all. When is the first day of fall?
Fall begins September 22nd and ends December 20th.
Oh, okay. For some reason, I was thinking today was the first day of fall. Today's the 21st. Oh, wow. Okay, it's going to be almost 90 tomorrow for the first day of fall. This makes me nervous about what our winter is going to be like. So if it gets crazy, one thing I'm not going to do is what I did years ago. I think it was 2011. We had a big ice storm, and I decided, and I didn't have like a YouTube channel or anything back then. I think I was just posting pictures on Facebook, but I decided it'd be a good idea to go outside and get pictures from the ice storm. And I had a Sony like point and shoot camera. It was the one that was like kind of rectangly. And I went outside and I was getting these great shots. That camera was fantastic. Sony's always been really good about letting you get really deep into manual controls, even on their little point and shoots. And this camera was no exception. And for 2005, which is when I bought that camera, that was really impressive. So I had that camera a long time. I had it like 6 years because I got it when I was still in college. And I think I killed it off in 2011 is when that happened. I was outside. I was getting these great shots. I mean, we had probably an inch of ice. I thought I heard Tuke. There he is. We had like almost an inch of ice. It was so cool looking. It was terrifying to drive in because it was brutally cold and they couldn't get any of the ice melt stuff to work on the roads. I think our office shut down for 3 days, but I was outside like an idiot taking pictures. And it was to the point where I had to like scoot back up my driveway because it was so slippery. So I'm getting these great shots, fall down, bam. Camera goes sliding all the way down the driveway, down into the street, down the street. So I'm like trying to get back at the camera. I've kind of messed up my wrist. The camera lens is like totally bent out of shape. Shot the camera. I was so bummed because I love that camera. And then I didn't replace it for a while. Not until I started doing Tech Uploaded. And then that's when I got the camera that TUCat broke. But if we get another ice storm, I definitely will not be going outside with the 70D. I don't know what I'm just not going to take pictures if there's an ice storm because I don't want to break my phone. I don't want to break the new camera I end up getting. And I certainly don't want to break this. But if we get snow, that'll be something to get. Ori in the blind forest. All right, better pause that before I get slammed with a copyright strike because, you know, YouTube. Had one of those moments where I was kind of sitting on the couch and then it occurred to me there was something I was supposed to do on Monday and I forgot to do it. So got it done, still okay, it's all good, but done. So now I'm caught up on all of my tasks of the week. I usually keep like a to-do list, and it's on 3 different sheets of paper right now, so I'm kind of thrown off. And then I ended up being out of the house Monday, and just like, I got off my usual routine, and I'm a routine-driven person, so that's not good. Anyway, I need to register my video mic. Anytime it's something that's related to the camera that has a warranty, I like to at least register it and hope for the best if something happens. Hopefully it's registered and hopefully it gets repaired, worst case scenario. So, you know, it's worth a shot. It's worth a shot to register the warranty for something. So anyway, yeah, I need to clean up in here. I think I started talking about that earlier, but I need to clean up in the area I can see. And I have those foam things for the wall. I need to get the rest of those put up. It's spooky monitor lighting time. Simply because I'm too lazy to get up and turn on the light. Because the switch is all the way over there, like 10 feet away. Anyway, chatting on Facebook right now with one of the TUVlog viewers. Actually, I think he views a lot of my videos. But anyway, always a good time to kind of chat with people that hit me up on the message section. That's why I always say get on Facebook and like join the conversation, the community, because I am pretty engaged with people on Facebook when I can be, when the time is there. And I got time right now. I'm just kind of working on various things and doing some stuff at my desk, so I'm able to jump back and forth. And it's really helpful because I get some nice feedback on the videos and the areas where I can improve and do things a little bit better. And I really appreciate that. There's a difference between being an ass in the comments and just saying rude stuff and giving constructive feedback. I always appreciate constructive criticism. There's areas where I definitely know I can improve. For example, in this conversation it was pointed out, I do this too much in my review videos. I wander over to the viewfinder, and that's just, I think I made the analogy that it's like a dog with a squirrel. I need to flip the viewfinder away from me when I'm recording for the review videos, because it's, for some reason too, especially when the camera's further away, it's even more distracting because it's this constant movement just off to the side of the lens, and it causes my eyes to dart over to it a lot. So I'm just gonna start flipping that around. So hopefully that makes that better. Someone had suggested I need to get like a Lazy Susan or something to like rotate products around when I'm reviewing them. Still working on that one. I haven't found one that I really love yet, but I wanna get one if I can that's motorized so I can kind of make it controlled while I'm doing the B-roll shots. I think that would be cool. Some of the other criticism I got was I move around too much in the vlog and it's shaky. And actually the person I'm chatting with now said that they appreciate that I set the camera down more. And that's just simply because I invested in a small tripod, which is something I should have done a long time ago. I had the one that I could like hold it with, and that was okay, but it was like really short. So I would literally have to be looking like this to be talking at something on the desk. This one's about, I don't know, is this thing 10 inches, a foot probably? It's probably a foot from the base to, you know, where the camera is, but it can be adjusted. It's the bendable tripod, and that's made things so much better, so much easier. So yeah, all like little improvements. So I appreciate that stuff. Just saying, that's why I say join the Facebook community and hit me up on Twitter and stuff, because a little bit more of a conversation can get going that way, where stuff tends to get kind of lost in the comments. I am going to do a better job of looking at the comments, especially on the vlogs and like recent reviews. Going back to older videos is hard because everything gets kind of lost in the mix, but especially with recent stuff, I am going to try to do a better job of that. But Facebook and things like that, that's where I can really kind of get a back and forth going, and I love that. So much fun. So anyway, just throwing that out there. I really should get up and get away from this computer though. I've been here far too long at this point. I need to stretch my legs. Maybe I'll go for a walk. It's dark, but it's not late, so I could still do it. Oh yeah. Mail's here. Well yeah, here we go. All right, so this is Mr. Embargo. This is the case that I can't talk about until after this vlog goes live, so it'll be okay then. I'm gonna get him out of the way for a minute. First things first, let's take a look at this box. I have a feeling I know what this is. At least I hope this is what I think it is. Hopefully it's my phone. So, I really didn't need to put tape on that. That was hard enough to open without it. So let's dig in. Man, this box. Samsung Galaxy S7. So I have a phone now to go with my Ting card. So pop this open. Everything looks to be in order. This is the international silver version of the phone. Very reflective. Let me get out of the frame so I can actually focus on it. So yeah, feels good. Compared to my iPhone, they feel pretty similar in size, which is nice. So those are pretty on par with each other. I'm not going to feel weird using this, you know, like I would with some giant device, which was my concern with the Android stuff. I tried the Moto X Pure or whatever it was called. I wasn't real happy about how big it was, but the price was really appealing and it arrived DOA, so that was a bummer. Sony RX100 IV. Hopefully this camera works out. I don't know. I think my issue is I'm not comfortable with the Canon point and shoots for whatever reason. We'll see, but whatever this does, I've got to make it work because I can't keep jumping around with different cameras. Now the big question is, let me get the phone out of the way here. I feel like there's something on my face. See what's in this guy. This says that it's supposed to be VR friendly. This is a case from NZXT. The review will probably be up by the time you see this vlog. S340 Elite. All right, it's an S340 variant. That makes me happy. I hate reviewing stuff that is kind of subpar. Like when I did the AI Crystal case. I loved how that case looked. It was an awesome case. And it's just, to this day, when I walk in my office, and I say to this day, like years have gone by, it's been less than a week, but when I walk into my office and I see that case, I legitimately say to myself, damn, that looks good. But that case was not fun to build in, and that was a bummer to have to say. So I like when cases deliver, but not this. Felt cheap. If this is like the last 340, it won't feel cheap. They got it right on that one. If you're curious what my first impressions of this case were, legitimate first impressions, you're getting them now because it's happening. So it says giant window, getting better with VR. Now, okay, here's where I was curious. What is it about VR that this case does so special? Getting VR up and running with this case is a snap with the HDMI and USB port connectivity readily available from the top panel. Aha! The magnetic cable management puck allows users to wind up VR cables with ease or split the puck apart for longer cable coverage. And it says giant window, all steel construction and tempered glass panel. Guarantee a crisp view of your system. The S340 Elite is made to highlight your build so your efforts will never go unseen. Tempered glass? Huh? All right, enough talky talk. Let's do it. It's kind of hard to get out of here. This is as good as it's gonna get, but here's the case. You can see the puck thing they were talking about right there. There's a VR headset on there. Apparently the HDMI ports are right up on top. It's a big tempered glass window, and it is just one piece of tempered glass. Very similar to the AI Crystal, although not as exposed. They do still have a little bit of a cutout situation going here, hiding a little bit of it. Let's take this thing out of the box. Let's take a look at it. All right, so caution, tempered glass, handle with care. We've seen this before. The panels seem to be 5 mil, it looks like. The case does have some weight to it. It is using the S340 side panel on the other side, so it is just standard black. So that's cool, pretty slick. I really liked the S340, I thought it was a good case. This is definitely a nice improvement. HDMI and USB on the top. It even says VR on there for the HDMI USB ports. So I'm gonna go set this down before I break it. It's gonna be a little overkill, but I am gonna use this motherboard in there. I'm finally gonna do that Xeon build. Hopefully it fits. It's a big motherboard. Looks like it should. It's an ATX case. It's a cool box. It's got a nice texture to it. The packaging, I wish that they hadn't used hard foam. They used softer foam in the AI Crystal case, but you know, what are you gonna do? Looking forward to that. That should be fun. Way to go, NZXT. Now I just wish I had a VR headset. Hint, hint, somebody send me a VR headset out there. I'm just kidding, but I wouldn't cry about it. Not gonna lie. I don't think anybody would. So anyway, that's it. Long clip. I need to get my phone activated and I need to test out this Sony camera. So the next clip will be me after playing with the Sony camera. I'm either gonna be okay or very angry. All right, first video on the, Sony RX100. I was gonna go outside and show you a giant mushroom growing in the yard, but then a big van pulled up and blocked my way. Didn't really block my way, but it like literally parked right in front of where the mushroom was, and they're offloading some people. Some handicapped people live next door, so I'm gonna wait for that to move before I do that. So here is the mushroom. You can see nothing else really happening in the yard. Yard's looking pretty good. Look at this guy. It's like Super Mario Brothers out here. That's a legit mushroom. I have a feeling if I ate that I would die though. It's really hot out today again for some reason. Today is actually officially the first day of fall. I almost said spring, that's wishful thinking. But yeah, today, first day of fall, and it's almost 90. What does it say? 85, close enough. I exaggerated a little bit, okay? Well, it's official. I am now an Android user. The Galaxy S7 is set up and ready to go. So, I took my iPhone. There's like so many apps that I have installed that I kind of forget which ones I use and which ones I don't, so I actually had to go back and try to figure that out, so. But that's done, so that's good. And it's almost time for me to post the video review for the keyboard. So I need to actually go get prepared to do that. So I'm gonna venture into my office here. I need to get another one of those little bendy tripods for this thing too. Those are really handy. I didn't think I would use it as much as I did. I use it all the time. Let's get this thing posted. Oh yeah, and the Sony camera is officially up and running. It's official, it's now a thing. I need to get a better stand for it though. I think of that one stand's just so nice, right? That one tripod. But I don't want to keep the 70D constantly mounted to that because I have to keep going back and forth between the tripod and then the little small tripod and the full-size tripod, and it's like kind of a pain to get the screw in and out of the bottom of that thing, and I'm afraid if I do it too many times, I'm gonna end up screwing something up. So I gotta figure that one out. So I just unboxed some fun stuff here and realized I didn't hit the record button. So, whoops! Anyway, so I got two very small things in the mail from Amazon, and I mentioned the size here because I had this little phone case, and then this package, which before I completely mangled it to get the card out, was that big. So two very small things. It was just a little micro SD card, which I have hiding in there, but this is to put in the phone. So I decided it'd be safest just to keep it in the little adapter that came with it. Anyway, these two little teeny things, they could have shipped in one of their like weird envelope things or any of the other packaging, but whoa, hitting the camera now. They shipped in a full-size box. Like, really, Amazon? I mean, I guess. Sometimes they send stuff in really strange-sized boxes. Like, I've gotten huge boxes from Amazon before for things that weren't very big. I've got stuff that's all over the table here. Anyway, got a case for the Samsung S7. It says, something you want. If you say so. I mean, obviously I do. I paid for the case. It does have a nice, grippy, rubbery feel to it, though. That's nice. I've got this cheap phone, and it kind of has a similar feel to it. Cheap phone case that literally I got from China, and I paid like $1.50. Something got on me. Is there pizza sauce in my hand? But it's breaking. The one from my iPhone near the... you really can't even tell. I actually have to kind of cause it to snag. It's breaking up near the camera, though. You cannot tell just looking at it. Unless I actually like push it out. So for $1.50, I got my money's worth out of this iPhone case for sure. This one was like $9, so a little bit more, but still not breaking the bank here for this stuff. So I've got everything charging right now. I've got the Samsung phone charging, it's almost done. I've got the Sony RX100 charging, I think it's almost done. This camera's battery is almost done, it needs to charge. So everything's charging, waiting for all of that. I'm gonna let this stuff do its thing. I'm gonna go watch some either Netflix or YouTube, I'm not sure. And what else? Oh, and then I need to make the review for the Fire Rose First Player Mechanical Keyboard. I need to make that live around 5 o'clock today. All right, I started the process of posting that video and somewhere along the line, I got totally distracted. So. I don't know what happened. This is the thing. There's so much going on today. There's so many things that arrived. The case arrived. I'm starting to plan for that. The freaking phone got here. Got that all set up. The Sony camera's here. It looks like it actually can focus the way the old camera did, which wasn't great, but is okay. It's better than the G7X was doing. The G7X, it was just a weird camera. It took really good pictures, and the video when it was in focus was nice, but it tended to overexpose a lot, too. Even a 70D does that a lot. If I leave, like, ISO and auto, it really likes to kind of shoot a little high. Must be a Canon thing. Whereas the Sony kind of seems to shoot a little under, but I don't know. Anyway, gotta get the review posted for the clickety-clackety keyboard. I switched back over to the Roamer G, I'm not gonna lie. I kind of missed the first player keyboard. It's just not as cool. It doesn't do as many things, doesn't have the volume knob, and it doesn't have the light up keys that I can set the way I want. And I just need to get used to the Roamer G again, that's all. It took me a while to get used to it the first time. I'm gonna see how this camera handles sunset. Yes, I'm looking at the screen right now. I kind of have to. It's the only way I know how things are working. So it looks like it's seeing my face. Is it holding focus? Because this is where the Canon was kind of freaking out, right? You saw that in that video. All right, let's go outside. I expect it to be able to not hold focus right now because it's super dark right here. But, all right, here we go. Venturing outside. There are a lot of people outside tonight. Oh, wow. Look at that sunset. Holy cow. I gotta get some pictures of this. Look at that. Look at that sunset. Wow. That is amazing. Just amazing. I can't believe that sunset. Let's get a little more footage of that. So beautiful. I'm glad I walked out here just to try the low light. I would have missed that.
I was asked to give TUCat a hug, so that's what I'm doing. Oh, you're stuck, Willie. Your claw's stuck. Ow, ow! TUCat, hug fail! Mass panic, TUCat. Mass panic. Sorry, Jared. I tried. Are you gonna come back for more? Whoa. In my face, man. He got hung up on the couch, which means I'm gonna have to trim your claws. What happened there, TUCat? Did you have a fail moment? It's okay. It happens. This is what happens with TUCat and how I know it's time to trim his claws. He gets hung up on stuff. And he's pretty good about keeping his claws in check. He scratches his post on a regular basis, but sometimes things just get out of hand and his claws get really, really long. And he hates it so much, to the degree that he gets so worked up, he usually throws up, that I try not to trim his claws on a regular basis, but when he gets to the point where he's getting hung up on things, then I get worried about his safety, so we have to do it. He's giving me that look like he knows. He knows. He knows it's coming. That's the look of a cat that knows trouble's coming. We gotta do something, Willie. Whoa. Someone's giving me a grouchy face. Now I have two phones that go off when things happen. Somebody hit me up on Twitter, apparently. This is going to be a thing now for the next month, having two different phones. I've got the Ting phone and the AT&T phone. Once I get through a month of Ting service, then we'll kind of see how it's going. More than likely, I'm going to stick with it. So far, you know, thankfully today, it seems like the service has been absolutely fine. I had a very nice long phone call, had no problems. Text messages are going through, no problem. So, yeah, we'll see. But my AT&T bill is just crazy high because I'm the kind of person that uses just the wrong amount of data every month. I use enough data to put me past the low tier, but not nearly enough data to make it worth paying for the next highest tier that I'm on. So that right there is going to save me some money. And then just kind of paying on still on pay per minute basis. I'm not paying for the unlimited minutes and the unlimited texts, so that's going to lower it a little bit too. This sounds like a Ting commercial. It's really not. I'm just trying to find a way to save some money on my freaking cell bill because it's crazy. Plus, rolling my own device, that helps as well. So I'm just going to pay off that iPhone, turn around and sell it, and just get that thing out of the picture. And then I was actually able to secure a really sweet deal on the Samsung Galaxy. So that worked out well in my favor. So overall, yeah, I'm being cheap. That's all there is to it. But so far today, I really haven't noticed that much of a difference between using the iPhone and using the Galaxy. I mean, the same apps are on both of them, and both are quick phones, and they're both about the same size, so six in one hand, half dozen in the other, is that the phrase? Also, I don't mean to curse myself here by saying this, but the camera, have you noticed the focus has been actually staying on me? Again, it's just like the old Sony cam. It takes it a couple of seconds to catch the focus, but it seems like once it does, it keeps the focus. And that's the important part. So maybe I just like the way Sony's work better. The Canon, in video, was faster for the most part at autofocusing. If I pointed it at something, it would pick it up usually. And it did have the touch screen, so I could touch the screen, and 9 times out of 10, it would focus on what I touched. Whereas the Sony, if I hold something up to the camera, sometimes it takes it a second. However, it locks on the target and keeps it. That's the key point here. If I'm telling you to focus on something, stay focused on it. Don't be floating around for after a couple of seconds. So that was my issue with the other one. It seems like it's got it together with this one. So I had to step up to the RX100, but you know what? The RX100-4, but you know what? It's a fantastic stills camera. I've been having a lot of fun with it today. Going into manual mode, playing around with that. And then I like that it's, you know, if I want to in video,
I can go through and set it exactly how I want. And one of the things that I do like that I can do, my eye's starting to water. Hopefully that's not a sign the eye thing's coming back. What was I talking about? Oh, like I can do a shutter priority. Really easy on here. Just tell it, I want shutter priority. Boom. I can do 1/50th. I know some people say you should do 1/60th on a 30 frame per second, but I like 1/50th. It gives me a little bit more light to work with and it still looks fine in my opinion. So anyway, I digress. The camera holds focus. That's what matters. That's what's important. That's what I wanted. So it sucks that I had to step up, but you know, I think Sony cameras and I on the point and shoot front, we just get along better. And a lot of people also complained about the menu system on the Sony. It is a little cumbersome. There's a lot of stuff in there. It's not nearly as easy to follow as Canon's menu system. I know, I've got a 70D. I'm very familiar with the Canon menu system. The Sony menu system is a little bit more on the complicated side, but it's still pretty straightforward. I mean, navigating it's straightforward. I hope in the next revision of this camera that Sony puts a touchscreen on this thing, because it really does need a touchscreen. But other than that, it's pretty easy to use, in my opinion. I mean, I can find everything. It's not a huge departure, though, from the system and the camera I was using from a few years ago. So, yeah, maybe that's why I feel kind of okay with it, whereas some other people are lost. But anyway, I'm liking this camera. So far, so good. Keep it up, Sony. Someone commented today, yes, they did, that Monroe was cooler than TUCat. Don't believe the haters, Willie. Anyway, I picked up some of these when I was at Meijer the other day because they were on sale. I had to know. Harvest Ranch, or Harvest Snaps Wasabi Ranch. I was mixing up the two words. You know what? I'm not gonna lie. They're pretty good. I didn't think they'd be good. I don't think they're at all green peas. They taste like they're made out of the same thing that Funyuns are made out of. First ingredients, green peas. So I guess this is what happens to a green pea when you bake it. They claim to be baked. Anyway, it says 50% less fat, good source of fiber, low sodium. Here's one of them. I gotta get out of the frame or it's never gonna focus on this. Anyway, that's what one of these things looks like. Pretty good. I'm not gonna lie. They're not as natural and all good for you as they lead you to believe. I mean, the ingredients list is not short by any means. Wow, they put a lot of logos on the side of this box. I hadn't really looked at this box until now. I just kind of took the camera out and started using it, but look at all of that. I took some shots of the sunset today and it did a very nice job. I was even able to transfer them over to my phone, which was really nice. And let's see if I can get some of them up here. I was really shocked at how well some of these pictures came out. So these are transferred over to the phone from the Sony. Look at that sunset. I got this, obviously you saw it on video, but if you're curious what the photos were, this one's like one of my favorites right here. Look at that. I did the just like phone transfer thing from my iPhone using the cable to this phone. It worked pretty well, but it pulled up some really strange, like, apparently I got this on my birthday last year. Don't remember that. And I had a coworker that screwed up a lot. Very nice, but she screwed up a lot. And whenever she did, I would send this. She didn't like that. I'd hear, stop it, from her office. But she did kind of remind me of that sad cloud. She was one of those people that's just kind of sad all the time, really. And that fit her so well. Oh, remember Mr. Tibbs, the cat that was afraid of the thunder? I got some better pictures of him. For instance, here he is, looking like an owl. Tomorrow I've got to write the script for the voiceover for the S340 Elite, and then I need to do the B-roll so that Saturday I can do the build and the review. I'm excited to see them focus on the S340. There was so much attention given to the H440 by NZXT for so long, understandably. I mean, it was a very popular case for them. I think it's still a very popular case for them because my H440 build videos from like 2 years ago still get comments every single day. So they're getting views still, and they're getting engagement. So the case is obviously still very popular because people are watching those videos. So I don't know, maybe I'll do a build video on that thing. The NZXT cases seem to draw people in, but I was getting really tired of the H440. I'm like, okay, I've used it twice now. I've done every cooling configuration I could think of besides going custom water cooling in there, which would have been a tight fit. I was just bored with that case. And then the S340 came along and I really liked it, but then it was just kind of like, that was it. They didn't really innovate with it anymore. Came out with a couple of other colors, and that was about that. Whereas with the H440, they had like the Razor edition. I think there was another special edition, and then they had like a blackout version and a regular black version, and then all the different colors with like the blue and the red and the white, and I think they had the green might have been the Razor one I'm thinking of. But anyway, they just did so much with the H440, and then I felt like the S340 is kind of didn't get the attention it deserved. I thought it was a really nice case. I really like my white S340. Which, strangely enough, is what I'm going to take some of the parts out of to do the build in that one. So, yeah, I don't know. I'm glad to see that they threw that threw the tempered glass on that one and kind of prettied it up a bit. I'm just very annoyed to see they used that same expansion slot thing on there. And I think some people thought I was a little bit harsh on Anadies for getting so bent out of shape about that. But until you've built in the computer, trust me. Don't think I got too bent out of shape about that. It was a pain. This one probably won't be as bad because I think the way that the back bracket is designed, you can remove it without interfering with the GPU or any of the other slots. The one in the AI crystal, the thing that slid over the expansion cards had to bend into the case to remove it. So if you removed it to put it in the graphics card, you couldn't slide it back into place to lock it in after your cards were installed because at least with my GPU, being that giant Asus ROG card, it was too fat, you know, coming from the slot outward. It was too fat, and it came out too far, and it blocked you being able to put that back in. I don't think this one's going to be the same. I think it'll be all right. It's still going to have the issue, though, of the screwdriver having to run directly along the case and kind of having to... I had to screw the screws in for the expansion cards at a slight angle, because the screws are so close to the side of the case and my screwdriver is just a little too thick because it has the replaceable bits on the end of it. So yeah, I'm a little annoyed by that. Just leave the screws inside the case. So what? You see some screws. Big deal.
Well, the plan to go to bed early didn't pan out. But it seems like it's always late at night when I end up in Twitter conversations. I don't know why. Probably because most of the companies and people I'm talking to are overseas. The time that I was getting into a conversation with A-Data and Charles about the moon pies or moon cakes. And moon pie. I can't stop calling it moon pie. RC Cola and a moon pie. But the moon cake thing. That was late at night. Now it's Noctua and I have been going back and forth just kind of poking fun at each other. Because I was giving him a hard time about not having black fans. They do have the industrial PPC black fans. But when I looked at those when they first came out, I asked Noctua what was going on with those, and they said, well, they're really designed for servers, so silence really isn't our priority with those, cooling performances. Apparently, when I was gone from the channel in November of last year, they came out with 24-volt industrial PPC PWM fans that will spin like way down and actually be quiet. Who knew? I didn't know that. So they sent me the press release, and I was like, oh, I blame my contact at Noctua for not keeping me informed. Although I wouldn't expect the person to because I wasn't doing the channel at that point. So, but I'm not going to tell Noctua that. I'm going to see if they respond back to it. But anyway, just fun stuff like that. Stupid stuff. That's when companies engage people on Twitter, that's cool to me. I would like to work for a place that encourages their employees, their social media person, to actually engage with people. Because I've worked places before where that was frowned upon. So I wasn't really sure why we had a Twitter account, but I digress. Anyway, having fun with Twitter, that's what I'm getting at. But it's also 1 o'clock in the morning, so I really do need to retire to the bedroom and finally get some sleep so I can get started with my day tomorrow. I keep feeling like I have something to do tomorrow, and I can't remember what it was. But it's, wait a minute, what is today? Is it Friday?
Yeah, it's Friday tomorrow. I can't keep my days of the week straight anymore. I need to take the trash out. That's what I was thinking. Maybe that's what I'm thinking of. I feel like there's something I'm doing tomorrow, though, and I can't put my finger on it. It's kind of driving me crazy. Realized my hair was looking kind of crazy in the last video. So I figured I'd go super crazy. Look how long my hair is getting. Really need a haircut. Kind of goes back down. This side's kind of nuts. You guys, I'm getting way too comfortable with you in this vlog.
What are you doing tonight, sir? Anything wild going on in the house? You've been keeping an eye on the front window. Anything I should be aware of?
Whoa, Windows 10. Kind of scary.
All right. Friday came and went. I didn't do a whole lot, not gonna lie. Wasn't feeling super hot, so just kind of took it easy. Got a lot of stuff organized on my computer. Actually got a bunch of my files backed up and just really boring stuff. So I didn't really share much because who cares about me backing files up and taking a nap? So, you know, that was what it was. It's still a mess in here, so I'm gonna take care of that as soon as I get done with this clip. And then I'll show the cleaned up environment. One thing that I need to do, I need to actually start preparing for getting a dumpster over here. So it's supposed to cool down next week, early next week. So I think that's when I'm actually going to, I'm gonna start moving stuff into the garage, and then I'm gonna get some pricing on what kind of dumpster to get. The problem is I've got, something on my lip, I think maybe. I've got a lot of old electronics that aren't necessarily working anymore, but still have toxic chemicals in them. You're not allowed to throw that kind of stuff into a standard dumpster. You can only do like cardboard and drywall and basic stuff. If you put electronics in there, like I've got an old tube TV that nobody wants. I've tried to give it away. It's like a 36 inch gigantic old standard def tube television that weighs, I don't even know how much, 4 times what that TV back there weighs. And I've put it up for free, and nobody wants it. So I'm gonna have to throw it away, but I can't put it in a standard dumpster. So that's why that's kind of been on hold, I guess. But I'll figure it out. I'll do something. One thing that's been fun for the last couple of days has been this little Ting experiment I'm doing. So basically I told Ting I'm gonna use it for 30 days and then do a video on my experience, you know, how it went, how my service was, you know, the ease of setting it up on a device, that kind of thing. So that'll be its own separate video, but anybody watching the vlog is gonna kind of get it behind the scenes on this whole thing. So I've got a Samsung Galaxy fingerprint magnet S7, which, you know, all the reviews said this thing's a fingerprint magnet. They weren't kidding. Now, the iPhone's just as bad on the screen. I mean, they're both, you know, glass, so that's an issue. But the back, not so much. I actually took both the phones out of their case to do this. And you can see the Samsung is really, really reflective. So, you know, I could have gotten black. This is the international version of the S7 because I wanted to get something that was unlocked. Plus, the international version actually has a faster processor than the Snapdragon. For some reason, the US got the less capable chip in the S7. I'm not entirely sure why that was. But anyway, the US version of this phone likes to be tied to carrier networks. But the international one is GSM unlocked. So I went with that, but they were kind of hard to find in stock. The white, forget about it. Getting your hands on that, which is what I really wanted, that was like every place had them back ordered. And I wanted to get it, excuse me, sniffles today. I wanted to get it from someplace reputable, like directly from Amazon and not a third party vendor or someone that's fulfilled by Amazon. Because I was reading reviews and people were saying that they were getting counterfeit phones, used phones, phones that had already been activated that they couldn't activate. So I was like, I'm just gonna order what they have like direct from Amazon. So if something's wrong, I can return it and there's no questions. And all they had in stock was silver, but I was like, well, that's cool. I just didn't wanna go black because I've been using black iPhones for a really long time. That was like, whoops. That was pretty much all you could get through work. And honestly, I grew kind of tired of them. But I'm having to be super careful with the Samsung because I don't have a screen protector on it yet, and I'm gonna eventually get a skin for it to put on there. The iPhone, the case finally broke like completely. So I've just been kind of rocking it without the case. The case was also like causing dirt and stuff to get stuck in this thing, and I'm actually scratching some of that out now. But it's in mint condition. So when I go to sell this, you know, it shouldn't be an issue. But I put iOS 10 on it, so now when I pick up the phone, you know, if it's sitting on the table, it thinks that I want to unlock the device. So let's, you know, comparing these two. So this is on AT&T. This is on Ting, which is T-Mobile. It's T-Mobile. That's who they use for the GSM network. Interesting experience so far. Data-wise, both of them are fine. I don't have any issues. This one goes back and forth between H+ and LTE a lot. So it's not, this one doesn't grab 4G all the time. And it's in an area on the coverage map that it's supposed to have 4G. The AT&T phone, on the other hand, always grabs 4G, and it's fast. I did a speed test, and the AT&T phone is significantly faster in data transfers than the T-Mobile. That being said, does it really matter for what I'm doing? I'm not streaming video over the data network because I don't have enough data to do that. Well, Ting, you just pay as you go, but on here, I have got 2 gigs per month of data. And, whoop, don't break the phone, Chris. And streaming video is a quick way to blast through that. Really, all I'm doing is like Pandora, checking email, going on Facebook, Instagram quite a bit. You know, that's my data usage when I'm not on Wi-Fi. So, as long as it's fast enough, if I'm getting 10 megabits or higher, I'm honestly not really gonna notice a big difference. I'm just not. So they're both fast enough. But AT&T definitely takes the win on overall network speed where I live. Call quality, that's a very different story. The AT&T network never drops calls for me, like ever. I don't think I've ever had a dropped call that wasn't related to either me or the person on the other end screwing up and accidentally ending the call. Typically, it either involves me putting the phone in my pocket and not having it locked, and then it like touches my leg or something and that's enough to set it off, or my mom goes to adjust her Bluetooth and it goes off, or I'm speaking to somebody that's using the headset and they'll accidentally like click the button, and then there's always something you can do. Now, Ting. I had one phone call on it with somebody in Wisconsin, and it was over a 2-hour long phone conversation, no problems. Then I tried to talk to my mom yesterday and I got disconnected 3 times in 30 minutes. And eventually I gave up and just called her back on AT&T because they couldn't keep the connection for whatever reason. No idea why. And the call quality was significantly worse on the Ting phone than AT&T. So then I thought, okay, maybe it comes down to iPhone versus, you know, the Samsung. So I thought, let's take the AT&T SIM card and put it in the Samsung Galaxy and see if the weird stuff is happening with the disconnects and the call quality and stuff like that. Now, I wanted to try the Ting card in the iPhone, but I'm actually currently waiting to get this unlocked. So I submitted the request to AT&T to unlock the phone, and I'm waiting. Both of these phones, the iPhone 6S and the Galaxy, I own 100% in full, and I'm not under contract with either carrier, AT&T or Ting. So this is basically me just deciding which way to go. I want to get a bill and kind of see where things are going to be. Now, I know I'm all over the place in this clip, but I wanted to share this with you guys. This is going to kind of go in the end video more than likely. There's still a lot of research to do, but AT&T was cool. I ended up getting a hold of them. And they were like, well, your device is paid off, so if you don't carry any device insurance and you're not making monthly installments, then we can, you know, they were able to throw in an extra little discount for me. They got my bill down to a very reasonable number. I'm at, with taxes and fees and everything, I'm at around $60 per month. And that's for unlimited calls, unlimited text, and 2 gigabytes of data with rollover. So $60 a month, running the math on Ting, if I make over 1,000 minutes of phone calls on Ting, my bill's going to be just about the same from what I figured out. Now, if I make less than 1,000 minutes of phone calls, my bill will be about $15 to $18 less per month on Ting. So it's that voice usage that's really going to get me in this case. And I conduct a lot of business with my cell phone. I'm on a lot of calls. I'm on conference calls. I talk to my family regularly. So
yes, I'm going to go over 1,000 minutes. My average is about 1,700 to 2,000 a month. So I don't think Ting's really going to cut it. But I do still want to keep using both phones because I want to get an idea for how Ting's going to work in the long run. So I can either make a recommendation or kind of tell people what I did so they can do the same thing to decide if it's going to be right for them. The thing I like about Ting, there's no contract, so I was able to just kind of roll a SIM card with them, use it for a month, and see how it goes. It's also giving me the time I need to transition people off of my AT&T number over to a new number, because once everybody is used to that, then I'm going to actually transfer the Ting number over to AT&T. They're probably going to have to give me a new SIM. That's fine. But I'm still getting calls from past jobs that I've had on my phone because I've had this phone number for so long. And anybody that's like a client or somebody I work with on a regular basis, I've given them the number for the Ting phone now. And that's kind of how I want to work this. I want to start over and get all of the junk out of there. So now the big juicy question at hand, and the one that sparks so much debate, which phone am I going to use long term? iPhone or Android? iPhone, Samsung Galaxy? I honestly don't know. I'm using both of them right now. I apologize for the sniffles. It's just going to be a thing until it freezes outside. So they both really have great things about them. iPhone's very thin, and it's very clean, and it's an interface that I'm used to, but there are certain things about it that just are starting to feel dated. Even with iOS 10 installed, I mean, yeah, it added some stuff to the messaging app, and, you know, it's just, I don't know. It's starting to feel like it's not innovating as much as it used to. I like the interface. I like that it's straightforward. You know, I'm very used to iOS. That's the thing. But after a few days of using Android, I'm really finding this phone to be quite snappy. The fingerprint reader works well. The phone has an amazing display. Each phone has its benefits, but what I will say is a huge benefit to the Samsung is the freaking camera. Oh my gosh, the camera is so much better. So what I did, I'm gonna pull this up. I took a shot in low light last night. Actually, I took a couple of them. I'm gonna have to stand up or the camera's gonna keep wanting to focus on my face to show these. And I'm gonna have to kind of stand in front of the camera. It's a little hard to tell because of the window reflections, but the iPhone's low light was really struggling with this photo. You can see once again, this isn't a screen brightness thing. This is actually just how the photo came out. The Samsung took a very crisp, clean photo, whereas there's some noise in the iPhone, and it's just, if you zoom in, you can tell that there's a little bit of noise to it. And I think this is because Apple overprocesses images sometimes if it's in a low light situation to do noise reduction. And when it does that, it comes at the cost of sharpness in the photo. Both of these cameras are 12 megapixels, so they should be capturing similar photos, but the aperture on the Samsung is far better. And I actually took some photos, you know, one of them of my Pebble, and you know, it came out really clear. So I was really happy with how that worked. And then, you know, at night, I took a picture on my nightstand of my remote for my television and my Roku. And then just for fun, it was a pretty low light situation. I took a photo just of my chair with, you know, the little duvet or whatever draped over it and a pillow. And this was a very low light situation, the shot was. And it came out very clean, very natural. You can zoom in, you can really see the texture on that blanket. So yeah, I'm pretty impressed with what I'm seeing. That's one weird thing. Swiping is a different direction on the Samsung than it is the iPhone. There's another shot that I took. It's just really crisp and clear. Really impressive. Anyway, that was a lot of information. I'm going to get to cleaning. I'll show you the end result when I'm done. And then more iPhone, Samsung talk, AT&T Ting later. Someone's texting me on my old phone number. Who could that be? My old boss responding to a group text from last night. I texted everybody and I said, start using this other number. I'm not gonna use this number anymore. And people are replying to me at that number still. I haven't talked in a while, what you been up to? Text me at the other number. That's why I texted you to begin with. Anyway,
Sorry, no. Didn't mean to rant, but massive improvement in the main living area here.
TUCat's getting kind of fired up about something. I don't know what his deal is right now, but...
What?
So yeah, that's all cleaned up now. That's looking good. Watching some disaster show on flights and crashes and stuff. I don't know why I'm watching that, but it's fascinating. Look at this. Dining area's back. Other than this cabinet here, we're looking pretty normal over here. Windows look good. Point those out, you know, since they did take a while. And the door. Well, since we're moving this way, this thing needs to go soon. It's just kind of in the way, and it's becoming an excuse for me to pile up stuff and just be kind of a hoarder. Here is the kitchen area. You can see the 70D sitting over there. And then kitchen area is back to normal, with the exception of the S340 case and the monitor, waiting for me to do B-roll and the review, because that needs to go up Tuesday morning at 10 a.m. Anyway, I've got a little bit of leftovers from yesterday, so I'm gonna have that for lunch, relax for a little bit, and then get to doing some B-roll over here. All right, it's happening, it's bright, it's review time. Well, actually, it's B-roll time. So you can see here is the fully disassembled case. Got everything in the viewfinder here. There we go. All right, so here's the S340 Elite. And you can see they made some nice little improvements here. Along the back, they've got these cool little, like, latches. These things are pretty handy. So I'm liking that. Cable management should be pretty straightforward in there. Here's the panel, and it's actually pretty substantial, which is nice to see. Thank you, NZXT. Then this is kind of the star of the show here. This is that tempered glass panel. And it's interesting, they opted to put some paint along here, so it kind of trims it out, whereas the other one was just completely exposed. And then this is the usual kind of cheapy front panel, but it looks good. I really like the finish on it. It's a fingerprint magnet, but it's that smooth finish, so that's nice. So yeah, the computer project is underway. Now I need to actually, finish the B-roll for one thing. Got my Pandora rocking while I work, so that's always nice. Then once I get done with all the boring B-roll filming, then I've got to actually do the build. I think I am going to do the Z97 workstation build in here. I want to use, when I did the S340 build last time, I used a micro ATX motherboard, so I think I'm actually going to do like a full-size ATX board this time in here, and I believe I do have a Kraken. Alright, there's an X61, X31. Now the X61 doesn't work, so that's not gonna cut it. Let's see, extra fractal fans. I believe everything is in here. Alright, as McConaughey would say, let's check this thing out. Okay, looks like everything is accounted for, hopefully. I don't know, is there an Intel bracket for this? Yeah? Intel brackets in there. I think everything's here. All right. Cool. We've got, no pun intended, cooling situated.
See the sweet hair right now? You know, looking in the viewfinder, it doesn't look as bad as I thought it would. You can kind of see it there. Anyway, that's late night computer building hair. That's what that is. I just was kind of sitting there and just decided I felt like building a computer. But anyway, yeah, I was just sitting there watching YouTube and wasn't feeling real motivated, and then all of a sudden I was like, TUCat. Really? What? Well, I don't know what to tell you. I don't know what you want. TUCat. Dang. TUCat's feisty about something. Anyway, so the motherboard has resurfaced. The old ASUS workstation board. Gotta love it. And then the rest of the stuff over there. I'm just kind of grabbing as I go, and I'm actually taking stuff from the other S340, the white one, which, by the way, I love this case. I forgot how much I liked this. It's just such a slick case. It's nice. I mean, it sounds cheap, but it feels solid. This was just a fun build. I remember really enjoying this one. So anyway, that's that S340. Pretty much the same thing. Pretty much the same thing as this one internally. This one has an extra SSD bay, and then on the back side there's some improvements for like cable routing and stuff like that, but there's not a huge amount of things different as far as the build experience, so that's a good thing. But yeah, it just felt like the time. It felt like the right time to just do some building, so that's what I'm doing. And TUCat apparently is all pumped about it. So, chatting with Robert on Facebook in the middle of doing it and doing cell phone experiments and all kinds of stuff. Just been keeping busy tonight, really. Just lots of random stuff. TUCat, are you helping? It's done. There it is. Got the X31 Kraken CPU cooler in there. And yeah, got the Z97 workstation board. Rocking a GeForce 750 Ti. Oh yeah, all the power. That's all I had. I think the build turned out clean though. Looks good. You can see the weird little contraption you have to use here for the bypass on the HDMI. This reminds me back in the day with the 3DFX graphics cards, where you had to have the bridge cable between your graphics and the 3DFX card. That's what that reminds me of anyway. That runs up here to this HDMI port for the VR ready stuff. Not that I'm ever gonna use that, but hey, I had to install it the way that it would be if you were going to, just to see how it works. So here's the case. Cable management was a breeze in here. There's plenty of room back here. They give you these nice little strap things to use, and yeah, it's no problems at all. The only thing that was weird was the way you had to mount the mechanical drive, and I actually did it right by accident. You have to put that in before you put in the power supply, because you got to come at the screw from this side over here if you want to put a screw on this side. This thing's not removable. So yeah, that part's kind of weird. Dude, you are spazzing out. How bright am I right now? That went well though. I think it turned out good. Hopefully it boots, so I gotta do that. Then I gotta try to hunt down an LED strip, I think. I feel like this thing needs some lighting. Otherwise it's not gonna show off as well as the other one did, because I had LED fans in the AI crystal case. This one has nothing that lights up other than the NZXT cooler. So I gotta go hunt down that strip that I had, that light strip. See if I can find it. Super illuminated TUCat. You're looking a little chubby these days, dude. You had a little trouble getting up there, too. Auto White Balance loves this. It has no clue what the hell to do with this situation. Anyway, build's done. Kind of give you an example of what this cable holding device thing that comes included does, but build's looking pretty good if you ask me. Turned out nice. It's real clean inside. It's just, it's really hard to tell because this camera is freaking out. And this tempered glass, I mean, it really does add. It's really slick. It's a nice case. I like it. So, but, you know, anybody that thought that the AI crystal was a little over the top, and I think the Corsair one is kind of very similar. It's mostly tempered glass. This one's just one panel of tempered glass. And it's not even the whole panel's tempered glass, but it's kind of painted, so there's still like a somewhat of a frame look to it. It's not just bang, glass on the side, which I like that look. I think it looks cool in the AI crystal, but this one compromises a little bit. So I think there's definitely something to be said for that if you're into a little less intense tempered glass experience. It's almost midnight. My hair is kind of crazy because I kind of dozed off on the couch, and I realized I don't know that I vlogged at all today. Can you see this here? I don't know. I don't have the viewfinder open. But yeah, I don't think I vlogged at all today. I did the video for the case, and then I did voiceover for the case. Then I edited the video and exported the video and got everything ready for the upload. And then I ate dinner and then I fell asleep. I'm a bad vlogger. I'm a bad vlogger, TUCat. Right? There you go. Now you can really see. Let me get that up there good. There we go. I'm gonna leave that like that because I know it's gonna drive some of you crazy. It would drive me crazy. Anyway, so thanks. I've been getting a lot of feedback. I wanted to say thank you for that on my comments on the frequency of the vlog, and it's so far unanimous. You guys want me to keep this pretty long. So, guys and gals, I should say, I don't want to forget my like 3% demographic according to my analytics of my female viewers. TUCat. But anyway, yeah, the long vlog format. So I'm going to stick to that. Not going to do daily. I thought maybe people would want daily. Honestly, I'm kind of relieved you don't. There would have been a certain level of accountability there that would have been good for me, I think, but I don't know if I'm ready for it yet. I need to gear up more towards it. Maybe I'll ease into it. Maybe I'll try to start doing the vlog twice a week, and then we can see how that goes and kind of go from there. But I'm trying to keep these shorter, so it's probably a good thing I didn't post a lot today, because hopefully that'll keep this vlog. I would like this vlog to be under an hour, and I've cursed myself now by saying that. So, new Sony camera debuted in this vlog. I think it was this vlog. And hopefully that's working well. I won't know until I actually go to edit. But it seems like it's working okay. I'm in like an extremely low light situation right now. I'm actually only illuminated by the television, which will be very clear when I do that. Now I'm sure I'm really awkward in the lighting situation and the hair. Yeah. That's probably driving people crazy. It would drive me crazy if I was watching a video. So try to keep this clip kind of short. Got another meeting tomorrow, and that's pretty much it. But I am going over to my parents' house, and I'm going to try to get some footage of their cat. It's debate night for the presidential race. So we're going to have an all-American dinner with fries, burgers, hot dogs, and apple pie, baby. So we're having that. We're watching the debates. We're going to play with the cats a little bit. There's a guy that walks his dog that we always look out for because the dog's kind of funny. Should be interesting. It's going to be a wild Monday. See how wild that is? I live a crazy life. All right, well, work for the day is all done. It's 4:00, so that went pretty quick. But productive morning / afternoon. I'm back. I've changed. I'm in my America shirt because it's debate night. That's right. So like I said in the last clip, going over to the family's house tonight for the debate. Gonna have an all-American meal. It's gonna be a little bit late when I get there because I think my dad's working kind of late tonight. Excuse me, we're eating a little late, so I'm gonna have to get a snack or something right now or I'm gonna be hungry. I'm back on the iPhone. I've got Ting running on the iPhone now. So what I did, I contacted AT&T and told them that I wanted the iPhone unlocked. And they did like almost immediately, so that wasn't a problem. And I was having issues with Ting dropping calls, like a lot. So I'd be on the phone 15, 20 minutes, drop the call. Call back, 15, 20 minutes, drop the call. So I'm like, all right, it's either the phone or it's the service. So I thought I'll just switch the SIM cards. I'll put the AT&T card in the Samsung Galaxy S7, and I'll put the Ting card in the iPhone 6S. So I'm 2 days into using the Ting card in the iPhone, and I haven't had any problems, so I don't know. It was the international version of the S7, which said it was compatible, and Ting said it was compatible, but it is missing like one of the LTE bands or something. It doesn't have the same exact connectivity as the US version of it, so I don't know if that's causing a problem. I don't know what the deal is, but anyway, the iPhone seems to be working fine with it, so gonna keep going. It is pretty cool. Again, this is not like a paid advertisement for Ting or anything. I'm just trying to save some money. I may also look at Google Fi, Google's Project Fi. I've had some people message me actually and say to check that out. I think someone even left a comment on the blog post. It says, my billing cycle doesn't end until October 22nd, so I got a lot of time still. Your bill is currently $21. So it kind of tells you, you know, as you're going, what your bill is going to be. Pretty cool. My bill, like I said, my last bill with AT&T was almost $98, but that's because there was $20-some for financing the phone, which I just paid off. With Ting, I may be with the minutes used in the $50 to $60 range, so I don't think it's going to be a huge savings, but Google Fi would be a huge savings because it's not my data that's the issue, it's voice. I use a lot of minutes. I'm like one of the rare people that still uses their phone. But I have a lot of calls. I have conference calls. I call family. It's just I'm on the phone a lot. So I got to have something that's unlimited. I have a feeling because Ting does hit you pretty hard for minutes. They're pretty easy going on data and text. But man, when you get over 1,000 minutes a month, they spike your bill. It goes way up. And then it makes it not so much of a benefit anymore. Hopefully I get some video of the cats tonight. My parents' cats, so that'll be cool. Wait until you see Polly. This is a big cat. I mean, this cat dwarfs TUCat. Big cat. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. I've got a couple hours to go before I head over there. I'm going to get something to snack on, and that's my day. Been busy. Been on the road, doing emails, did some work on a project. I think Devin, she was in the last vlog, is going to come over here to get some work done on her website and her... Maybe something on her YouTube, I don't know. Just so everybody's clear, I'm not endorsing what she has going on her channel anyway. I don't really know what she's doing. I know it's like health and fitness and she's selling some stuff from some company. I don't have anything to do with it. I'm not saying it's good. I'm not saying it's bad. I have no affiliation whatsoever with that. So a couple people actually sent me a Facebook message wondering if I was like teaming up with her. I'm not. I was just over there showing her how to use YouTube and helping her out with her website. That's it. So just throwing that out there. But wishing her the best. I'm sure her channel will evolve and change. And you know how that goes when you start a new YouTube channel. You usually start in one place and end up in another. So that's at least that was the journey for me. I transitioned from all kinds of different things. At one point, I did a cooking show. It wasn't on YouTube, though. It was on, what was it called? Blip TV or something like that? It's gone now. But that's what it was on back in the day. I was, like, kind of anti-YouTube, which, in hindsight, was probably a bad call. In 2008, 2009, but what are you going to do? So I kind of forgot I had this Nexus tablet from, a little over 3 years ago. The Asus Nexus 7. They have two Nexus 7s. And this was the Asus variant. I guess they were both made by Asus, but this was the more powerful one. I used this on my DSLR for a long time. I don't really use it anymore, but my iPad's getting kind of old. So this seems to be a little more responsive. Which is interesting because I think it's older than the iPad I'm using. I don't even know what iPad I'm using anymore. It's the old iPad. The older style with the Retina display. Maybe the iPad 2. I don't know. Regardless, I realized that I'm probably going to have to find a replacement for it. And that tablet actually fits the bill fine, so I'll just use that. It sat in a drawer for a really long time. I kind of forgot about it, and then I was like, oh yeah. TUCats following me. Oh, I can't escape you. According to my Pebble, I just got an email. Weight Watcher special flash sale. That's a mouthful. Weight Watchers special flash sale. I don't know what they're trying to tell me, but I think I'm kind of offended by it. I'm not really sure. TUCat, what? It's pandemonium in here. Off we go for All American Eats and a debate. Living the wildlife. Now, this is the first time I've used the new Sony camera in the motor vehicle before. Ooh, my grass really not looking super hot. A lot of weeds. Sun is setting, it's beating down on me from the west. It's actually a very nice sunset tonight, but I tried to get it on video, it's probably just gonna get washed out. Oh, I started watching Blacklist again. I'm like trying to remember what the heck happened in the show. Yeah, it's one of those shows where a lot of shows have the previously on thing, and on Netflix when you're doing a marathon binge, those are kind of annoying. But in this case, I kind of wish they did, because I don't know what the heck's going on. I watched seasons 1 and 2 a while back, and they just added season 3, like, fairly recently. And now I'm, like, trying to catch up and, like, remember what I missed and what was going on and all that good stuff. So, guy was nice to me there. It let me in. But, yeah, so trying to get to the bottom of what the heck happened in that show, because it did leave on, like, kind of a weird, like, cliffhanger thingamajiggy. Oh man, riding lawnmower people. What time is it? It should be well past rush hour at this point, I would think. Let me zoom in a little more. There we go. Maybe that's a little better. Come on, peeps. Let's get this done. A lot of traffic tonight. So, yeah. Wow, sun's really going down quick. I can't believe that it's already, like, basically sunset. It's only 7:15. I know I sound like a broken record. It's been so hot that, like, I'm not in the fall mindset at all. Like, not even close. It just doesn't feel right. Doesn't seem like it should be fall at all, if that makes any sense. It says 59 minutes left. If that is true, this memory card holds a lot. Because there's quite a bit of footage on here at this point, I think. So, yeah, that's cool if that's actually accurate. I'd yet to find a setting in the camera that actually tells me how much I have left on the battery. It's a little weird. Like, I don't know why that's so hard to find, but you used to just be under memory card and it would say, like, space available or something like that, but I've been through all of the menus and I can't really find much. People honking at each other. It's getting wild out here.
I don't know what that person was talking about either. The problem with these roundabouts is people don't fully grasp them. I think I've said this before, but sometimes people just do really stupid, dangerous stuff. And they'll just like play chicken with people and they'll pull out in front of them and just assume that they'll stop for them. Oh, so bright. Oh my gosh. I can't see. Lots of geese. There are lots of goose in the loose here. Oh, what is this? Yeah, just park in the road. Just block the whole road. It's not like people drive down this or anything. So anyway, I'm here. Next up, cat videos.
And it's my parents' cat, Mr. Tibbs. This is the cat that's terrified of thunderstorms. And this is where he's usually hanging out during a thunderstorm. And this is Polly. Giant TU cat. Well, he actually doesn't look too big right now. Polly, you're looking pretty good right now. Come here. There we go. That's more like it. Waiting for your moth. Floor is creaking when you walk. He's looking at me. Don't judge me. That is a big cat. Polly, you need to go on a diet. You are a giant TU cat. Look at the paws on this guy. Big paws. What are you looking at? He's kind of owl-catting right now. So big, dude. So big. It's a battle. Oh, you get your face stuck. Oh, he's like, give me some of that. Hello, sir. What you looking at? Keep an eye out. He's the guard cat of the house. Well, it's about 2:15 in the morning. Just now got home from being at the parents, and on the way back, I remembered TU Cat needs a fresh litter change, so I had to go pick up some litter, and along with that, food haul! That's right, a trip to the store would not be complete without a food haul, and I even had my groceries bag for me. I was in the self-checkout, and somebody working there was apparently bored and bagged my items. She really made a mean knot here, though. Look at this thing. She wasn't playing with that. All right, well, this is the fun bag. We'll get to that in a minute. First things first. Well, it's all fun. None of it's good stuff. It's not healthy for you. Got a frozen pizza. A very large amount of oven-roasted turkey, because they didn't have any other turkey besides this 16-ounce, 1-pound container. Some honey butter white bread. Again, not really the best choice health-wise. Tortilla chips, the cheap kind, of course. My usual generic kettle-cooked mesquite barbecue chips. Look at this pile happening over here. $1 a bag. So I got cheddar cheese cracker style, pepperoni pizza cracker style, pizzeria pretzel, and not to be left out, cheddar cheese pretzel. Combo score. All right, gotta go put this in the freezer. My garage light turned off quick. TU Cat watching from a distance, waiting for me to change the litter in his box. So good times at the families. The debate wasn't anything too crazy. It was pretty tame for a Hillary Trump debate, to be honest. So dinner was good, apple pie, burgers, hot dogs, french fries. I didn't have a hot dog, I just had a burger. I had a couple of turkey wraps for lunch at like 3:30, and then we ate at 7:30. So I wasn't like super hungry. I think it was actually a good call to have that little bit of a snack because otherwise I might have gone a little nuts. And then just kind of lazied around a little bit. Had to fix my dad's phone. My parents have Samsung Galaxies, like Galaxy J or something like that. And his email got kind of messed up. So I for some reason, those phones that they have like to drop the Wi-Fi connection. Like it'll say it's connected to Wi-Fi, but it doesn't transfer any data. So you have to restart the phone, then it works again. I've tried putting it in airplane mode and taking it out to see if that would help. It really doesn't. So you have to reboot the phone periodically and then he changed his password. It was a little minor thing. Just nice chatting with the family and hanging out as always. That's always nice. I like to get over there at least once a week, if not a few times a week. And you know, they're so close. It's good to have family that close. And you know, I never know when I'm going to move or go somewhere else. So I try to spend time with them as much as I can while they're, you know, basically right down the street. They're not down the street, but they're, you know, basically down the street. Anyway, I've got to change the litter in TU Cat's box because he's kind of giving me that look like he's got to take a dump and he needs fresh litter. So Gotta tend to the cat's needs. TUCat, he's finicky. Has to be a certain kind of litter, has to be a certain depth, has to be just right, so gotta hook him up. Also, I should add, shopping at 2 o'clock in the morning, not a lot of people. There was almost no one in that store other than employees. It was like weird, it was eerily weird. I've been in there late before and there's usually a few people in there, like a handful of shoppers, but it was a few employees and nothing else. So I walked from the back of the store over by like pet supplies, walked down the aisle, got the cat litter, didn't encounter anybody, started walking back towards the front, figured I'd see somebody on that stretch, walked down the main aisle area, nobody there, kept going, nobody down the other side aisles, just nobody. It was weird. But like I said, it was so slow that, one of the employees actually came up and bagged my groceries, which is really unheard of. So 2 o'clock in the morning on a Monday, I had to think about what day it was for a minute. Seems to be the time if you really want to get your shopping done with nobody bothering you. And a few of the people that were stocking shelves said hello and one guy waved. So very friendly bunch there tonight.
Yeah, time to get the dumpster. Oh, look at this. Look at my garage. This is ridiculous. All right, it is time to go get my ears lowered, as Grandpa would say. I am heading out for my haircut. There's gonna be some music. There we go. It is absolutely beautiful outside today. Holy moly. Tomorrow I'm cutting the grass. It's supposed to be cloudy and in the 60s, and that is just perfect lawn mowing weather, so that'll be good. Plus it rained quite a bit and the backyard does tend to get a little saturated, and when that happens, problems happen because the lawnmower stalls out. I'm gonna actually crack the windows a little bit so it may be a little loud, hopefully not too much, not like I'm going on the freeway or anything here. But just got an email. Haircut, 10 minutes, look at that. I have to say, the update Pebble made, I went a long time without wearing my watch, and then when I started wearing it again, there was this like massive update to Pebble's software and their firmware and all that good stuff, and it made a lot of nice changes. They've really upped the information in the health app and like the sleep tracking. I never really understood that though. I mean, how much can it really track your sleep unless you're wearing it? Oh great, school's getting out, so traffic's all backed up. It's gonna take me a while to get out of here. The problem is they set this light so that it doesn't change, so that all the buses can get out, but then it totally backs up anybody trying to get out of any of the neighborhoods. So that's a little bit of a problem. I wish they would resolve that. Had a guy be nice to me there, he let me out, thank goodness, because traffic's backed up all the way to this roundabout up here, which is pretty far. So it's just not, I mean, I understand why they're doing it because they have to let the school buses out, but it's really an issue when you've got a road with this much traffic on it, because people, they just can't get out of these neighborhoods, and they change it so that the light stays red for probably about like 10 minutes, and it just causes a hellacious traffic situation on one of the main roads that goes through this town, because they've got so much construction going on, they've closed down a lot of the alternate routes. So you kind of have to take this road if you're, you know, going north or south. And that's a bit of an issue, you know, when you're shutting down basically the only route people have, then you're gonna obviously have some massive, massive traffic problems. And that's pretty much what happens. So if you're trying to make a left out of your neighborhood like I was, and you don't have any other way to get out of your neighborhood, then yeah, you're in trouble. Got the video posted this morning for the case. It was nice actually getting a review up when the product came out. I feel like I've moved up to the next level. Usually I'm reviewing stuff after it's been out for a while. And it's typically how it works when you're a smaller channel especially. You know, the companies, they don't put you on the short list for embargo releases. They make you wait till it's been out and the first, you know, round of reviewers have gone through it. Well, I actually got this one ahead of time, so I was able to record the video, have it edited, and be prepared to launch the video on the morning and at the time of the embargo lift, which was nice. I've never done that before, so I was happy that I was able to actually do that. There is no parking here at all today. This is kind of tight quarters. All right, so I am here.
It's windy. Even my new dew is getting blown around. Definitely going for a walk later today. It is so freaking nice out. It is perfect. The weather is absolutely perfect. Sending some interesting text messages at the moment. 74 degrees and sunny and breezy and just nice. Also, this new Sony camera, it's significantly newer than the old camera I used to use, but I pulled the battery out of the old camera before I discarded it just to, you know, try to be a little environmentally conscious, and boom, it uses the same battery as the new camera. Awesome. So now I have a spare battery. Who would have thought that they would actually keep the same battery technology all those years? That's unusual that something would actually still be useful. So yeah, spare battery. Sweet deal. The NZXT S340 video has only been posted for about 8 hours, and I've already received a few comments regarding one of the cons that I listed for the case. And that was I complained a little bit that when I mounted the X31, which is like a small little 120mm radiator all in one setup, when I mounted it on the top area on the front, it took up too much space to be able to put a fan at the bottom. And that's true, but that's because I have it set up in a pull configuration. So I've got the radiator up against the front of the case and then the fan behind it pulling air in, because I prefer pull over push. Dust still works its way in, even with a dust filter, and I have a cat, so I get cat hair in there. Somehow it finds its way in, and then it like kind of gets, you know, tangled up in the radiator and all that. So I just find I have less issues when I use it in pull. I pretty much get the same temperatures. So, and there was a whole series of videos I did on pull and push pull and all that jazz in the H440. But anyway, I know that I get about the same performance either way, so I just prefer to use it in pull. Well, to do that in the front, the radiator has to be mounted to the front of the case. That causes the area below it to be taken up. Now, if I had mounted it in push, and this is of course with the front being on air intake, I want air from the outside coming in to hit the radiator, not the other way around. So anyway, had I put the fan in a push configuration, then the fan would have been mounted to the front of the case, and as you can see, had to take off the cover there in order for this to work. But as you can see, since the radiator dips down a lot more than the fan, if this was on the other side, then it would fit and it would kind of overlap the fan that was mounted down here. So yeah, you could definitely put a fan in then if you did it the other way around. I just prefer having it set up like this because I just preferred A, the look of the fans, the three fans, it's consistent. And I just like it in a pull configuration. So yes, you could set this up so that you can have a 120mm radiator in here and still use both fans. But in this configuration, you do still run into a little bit of a hiccup. So I stand behind my comment, because while you can use a 120mm radiator and a fan up front, you can't use it in every configuration. In my case, using it in an intake configuration with the fan set up to pull. So you have a little bit of a restriction there, but again, most people will probably just switch it around if they really want to have two fans up front, so not a big deal. But it's still something I think noteworthy of pointing out. Another kind of cool thing about this case is the fact that the panel is just completely clear, so you do get a really nice shot of what you have going on inside the build. But yeah, I have to say, this little X31 is doing a pretty darn good job for cooling. I mean, granted, nothing's overclocked or anything, but considering how small it is and out of the way, it is, it's quite a little performer, actually.
A lot of comments today on the S340 Elite video. It seems to be sparking interest in people. It really is a good case. There's a lot about it that's nice. Someone commented that it looks like the clips on the back are really cheap. They do look cheap. I was very skeptical of those clips when I went to go do the build, but they hold everything just fine. I was running a lot of cables through them. Some cables with a decent amount of resistance on them, and the clips didn't come undone. All of them worked. They stayed in place. So they don't look super substantial, but surprisingly, they are. So I don't know if that's something they can maybe improve next time, maybe make those clips look a little better, but looks are deceiving on that one. The case is $100, so it's about $30 more than I think the base MSRP in the other one. So you gotta decide, I guess, if the glass panel's worth $30. I think it is. Honestly, I think it makes a huge difference in the look of the case. Plus, you get the better cable management. You get a better dust filter on the bottom. And if you're into the VR thing, you do get the run to the front of the case if you're plugging in an HDMI cable for a VR headset. Not really an issue for me. I still haven't gotten into VR yet, but I know that a lot of people have been complaining that they have to get like extension cables for the VR headsets because they're not long enough. So I think NZXT heard those cries and kind of answered him with that case. But yeah, overall, pretty positive response to it. I think it's going to be a pretty popular product for NZXT. So I'm glad that I was able to take a look at it, and I'm glad that everybody seems to be enjoying the review, so that's good. Getting something out on day one definitely does make a difference. There's a lot more engagement happening on this video than a lot of my other reviews, and I think it's just because I was able to do it right as the product was released, which does make a big difference, so hopefully I can keep doing that. And hopefully, like I said earlier, they make better versions of some of the popular cases. The H440, I just find it very hard to believe that they wouldn't revisit the H440 and do something, maybe not even call it the H440, but do something that looks kind of similar to it with the tempered glass. Just my guess. This is by no means inside knowledge or anything, but I would be surprised if they didn't. As much mileage as I've gotten out of that case already with the Razer edition and all the different colors, if they don't do a glass panel version of it, I'd be surprised. All right, well, it's that time of the week. The time of the week when I have to get all of the footage pulled together for the vlog shouldn't be as bad for this one. I don't think I have nearly as much as I usually do, because thankfully it was kind of a slow week, which is a good thing. Sometimes you need a week where things are just a little bit chill, relaxed, not a whole lot going on. It was one of those weeks. And I'm kind of defining the week by vlog to vlog, so midweek to midweek, 7-day period of time. That's pretty much what I'm getting at here. It's actually chilly in this room, and that's really not common. It's usually pretty hot in here because of the computer. But yeah, I think I've got most of the files. I don't know. I think the only thing, I've got like a 64 gig card. I've got this 32 gig card. I think I have, the problem is I try to only record channel stuff on the 64 gig card and then vlog stuff on this 32 card. This is the problem with using multiple cameras for the vlog. I've got some stuff on the iPhone. I think I took a clip or two on the Samsung. I've got too many things in too many places is what I'm getting at. And then I gotta try to keep them all straight when I go to do the vlog. And sometimes that gets a little tricky. So like now I don't remember what I copied over. So now I have to wait until tomorrow to get the other camera that I ordered, but not a huge deal. Man, the house was a wreck when I started this vlog. See, this is the fun thing about doing the vlog, is it's always an experience trying to put two and two together as far as what I was actually doing in any of these clips, because sometimes I honestly forget, like,
here's how this is gonna sound. I feel like the other...
So I guess I'm assuming this vlog started on September 21st. That's when I took the first clip. So I hope that's right. But the Sony camera arrived. The RX100 floated into the scene somewhere midway through, I think, this vlog. So there should be a decent amount of footage on here. I'm not entirely sure. I really prefer using this camera. I know the audio is not as great and the quality's not as good as the 70D, but it's just so much more convenient. It's so much easier for me to be able to, I've got this camera on that little bendy tripod, and to move this camera around, I can just slide it out from the tripod, hold it in my hand, take it in the car, take it to my house, my parents' house. I can take this around with me. And the iPhone, I mean, it's okay with video. My problem with it is it does great audio quality-wise if I've got the phone facing me, but when I'm recording something else, it doesn't pick up the audio well at all because of where the microphone is on the actual phone. So that part of it's a little bit of a bummer because I'm not always just recording myself. So that makes it a little bit less convenient. And every now and then I get a clip on the iPhone that's just totally out of audio sync. And I actually have to adjust it in post by shifting the audio and video track a little bit to get things to line up. And that's kind of like a step I really hate to have to do when I don't have a reference point, because then I'm just going off of what looks right as far as everything being synced up. Whereas, you know, when I do the primary channel videos, I've got the audio from the 70D that I can line up with my field recorder audio, and then it's fine. And now that I have that, now that I have the VideoMic Pro, it's kind of like a nice peace of mind to have that as the backup, because if the audio, if something happens to the audio, either on the lavalier or the microphone I'm using or whatever, when I'm doing a video, the audio with the VideoMic Pro being as far away from me as it typically is still not gonna be great, but it's gonna be more salvageable than the audio that I would have gotten off of the on-camera microphone with the 70D. So it's a nice peace of mind, it's a nice backup. Also, one of the questions I got last time, and I forgot to address it because it came in kind of late,
Somebody asked me why I never record. I say I go to my parents' house a lot, but then you never see videos of that. And I got a little video this time with the cats, but to be honest, it was like a little awkward recording over there. My parents don't want to be on video. They've made that very clear. So I make a point not to get them on video. But then it's like, I don't know, it's just something's weird about it when I'm over there recording. I just, maybe I'll warm up to it a little bit more, but it's just like, I'm always like avoiding, you know, making sure that they're not in the frame, and it's a thing. So that's why I typically don't record over there. I'm just respecting their wishes. I never record anybody on the vlog that doesn't want to be on the vlog. And typically, you know, I ask permission. Like when I was at Devin's house in the last vlog, I made sure that her and her husband were both okay with me recording over there, recording inside their house, showing their pets. You know, it's, you got to be respectful. And they were really good sports about it, so that's cool. And, you know, my parents don't have any issue with me recording the cats or recording, like, in the house, but I just feel like they're not super comfortable with it, I kind of feel like, so I just typically don't do it very often. But I did want to show the cats, because the one cat's massive, and the other one's kind of a legend, the black and white cat. He has more personality than the other one. He is, he's a very, very loving cat. He's very obsessed with people. Willie, TUCat, he's pretty nice, but he takes a while to warm up to people sometimes, and honestly, he's just pretty boring. He's getting old, and he doesn't do very much, whereas their cats are a little bit younger, so they're still a little bit more active. That was kind of a long answer there for the why don't I record at my parents' house question, but I did want to address it. So that being said, I need to get the footage off of this camera now to move it over to the vlog folder, and I set the clock and I set the date on the Sony. I am really hoping that metadata is getting transferred over to the clips, because for whatever reason, in the last Sony camera I used, it wasn't. And that created an issue for me when I was trying to merge that footage with the iPhone footage and the 70D footage, because I was sorting it by date created. That way, even though I was using different cameras, I kind of knew what order everything came in. If this camera doesn't do that, I'm going to be kind of hosed. I'm going to have to go by what I'm wearing. That's my backup if the date stamp doesn't transfer. I try to piece together the narrative based on the videos from the other cameras and what I'm wearing that day, and that's how I kind of like try to stitch things together in the right order, but so much has been on this camera that that may be a little harder. Thankfully, I think Windows recognized the dates, so if anything, I can keep a Windows Explorer window open, look at the dates in there, and then just use that as my reference, but that's gonna get old pretty quick. So hopefully this camera is doing the right thing and it's actually transferring the things over that I need. We're plowing through these vlogs lately. When was the first one I did when I came back to the channel? So was it 18? Is that right? 7/18/2016. TUVlog 17 was completed on 3/9. Did I go that long? You're kidding me. There's no
Hello
way.
Hello everybody and welcome to the start.
Oh, that's still in my old office from my last job. That was March of 2015 was TUVlog 17. TUVlog 18 says July of this year. I went 16 months without doing a TUVlog? Wow, guys, I'm sorry. That's not cool. At least I've been regular now though, right? So this will be my 7th vlog upload since mid-July. I think I'm keeping on a pretty good schedule here. I'm feeling good about this. I feel bad about how long TUVlog 17 was. You know, today I was thinking, I was watching Netflix, then I jumped over to YouTube, I started watching some vlogs that I follow, and some other content, and it occurred to me, I haven't had cable in well over a year at this point, and I haven't missed it one bit. There is never a moment where there's not something for me to watch. There's never a moment where there's not something for me to consume, some kind of entertainment, and a big majority of it is YouTube stuff. Just YouTube creators putting stuff out there. That's just so cool to me that, you know, the days of big budget productions and, you know, having to spend millions of dollars to put something together, they're gone. I'm watching stuff on YouTube that, you know, pretty much anybody could do. And it's fun and it's entertaining and it's basically my primary source of entertainment. That Netflix, which Netflix, you know, especially now, it does have a pretty big budget on their productions. But still, between Netflix and YouTube, that's 99% of what I consume for my entertainment anymore. And that's just such a sign of the times, especially for my generation and all the ones, you know, before, would it be before me, after me? People my age and younger, that would be a better way to say that, I guess. I don't know why I'd struggle with that so much. But that is a large group of people who are consuming entertainment that is not cable television. And I know a lot of people don't even go to the movies anymore. Excuse me, I've got friends that have canceled cable, and they're in the same boat I am. They don't miss it at all. And it makes me more productive, actually. It, you know, watching stuff on YouTube is inspiring a lot of times. And watching stuff on Netflix is more entertaining to me than a lot of what I used to watch when I had cable. I feel it broadens my horizons more. It helps my creativity. And it helps me get more done because I don't have cable TV sitting there. And when I had cable, I always felt like I needed to be watching it because I was paying, you know, I think my bill with Bright House is $140 a month because I had the box. And then when I got my home theater PC, I still had to rent the card and the tuning adapter. And then I had the services. And then I had another box in the bedroom. And then the internet, which I still have the internet, which I'm paying, you know, out the wazoo for now because I don't have cable. But I'm still saving money. But I just felt like I had to be consuming it because I was paying for it. Now I don't feel like that. I just watch things on my own terms. And, you know, with Netflix and YouTube, you can just save things to a watch list or add it to your list and watch it when you want to. It's just so nice. And it's amazing that something that was such a mainstay of entertainment, cable television, is just disappearing for such a huge, huge chunk of people. And that's why the cable and satellite companies are panicking. Netflix especially is just a major blow to a lot of the cable providers. Totally unrelated, I need to get a new coffee maker because I have a really nice coffee maker that makes, you know, a full pot, and that's great, but I don't need a full pot of coffee. I live alone. So I had a single serve one, and it was really cheap. It wasn't a Keurig or anything like that. And then it finally broke after years and years. That's why you probably noticed since I brought back the vlogs, I am never drinking coffee. That's because I don't have a coffee maker. So let's see what Amazon brings up for singles. I typed single, and the first thing is single serve coffee maker. Oh, Amazon, you know me well. This is turning out to be more of a mission than I thought it was going to be. The one I had before was fine, and it was $30, maybe? I don't know. It might have even been in one of the vlogs. No, I think I had it before I even started this channel. Okay, well, I've just found the next hour of my evening. That's exciting. I need to find a coffee maker. I really do need my coffee back, though. So, unfortunately, I had to throw away some of the single-serve little packets. There was packets for this one, and they've gone bad at this point. It's been a while since I've been able to make coffee. Also, I just watched back the footage that I have taken with this new Sony RX100-4, Mark IV, I'm not really sure what to call it, the RX100-4, and wow, it's phenomenal. It looks great, and it seems to be holding focus, which is great. So I'm really happy with this purchase. This camera is so much better than the G7X Mark II. I don't understand why it's even a competition. I mean, the G7X just couldn't hold focus at all. Even in decent lighting, it couldn't hold focus. This thing, there are no lights on in this room except for a little teeny light behind my monitor and then just the lights from the monitor. The white balance has gone completely wacky, I'm sure, because it doesn't know what the hell to do with this. But it's holding focus on me, and it's crisp, and it looks good. So, yeah, I don't understand why this camera has the reputation of having horrible focus, and the G7X has, you know, supposedly better focus, when this one is just spanking the G7X. It looks better, and the focus is solid. So, I am a Sony fan once again for the vlog camera. Thank you, Sony. Keep being awesome. Keep doing good work, RX100.
So, I woke up this morning, came outside to cut the grass first thing because it's kind of been raining on and off all night long. So I thought I'd get a chance to get out here and get it this morning because it wasn't supposed to really rain that much today. And I look outside. What the heck, man? Look at this. I mean, do I just chance it? It looks like it's clearing up behind it. Other than that, it looks okay. So, I don't know. I think I'm gonna go for it. I mean, I gotta get it done. I think the grass is pretty wet too, but I gotta cut it. The backyard's getting kinda long, and if it gets too much longer, I'm gonna be in trouble. So, I'm gonna chance the storm and just hope I don't get hit by lightning.
Well, that didn't work out.
Okay, so, as you can probably hear, it's pouring down rain. and it really wasn't supposed to rain. I think it might be starting to hail. So probably a good call to come inside. I got part of the front yard done, and then it started to rain, and I'm like, I'm just gonna wait it out. Is it really hailing? It is. Let's check out this hail.
Yep, definitely hailing a little bit. Kind of hard to see on camera, but there's a little piece of hail. Some more little pieces over here. You can kind of just barely see them. Very, very small hail, but hail nonetheless.
So yeah, I tried to do it, and now I'm gonna have to wait it out. But if it keeps raining this hard, it's still hailing too. That's interesting. If it keeps raining this hard for too long, I'm not gonna be able to do it today because it's gonna get oversaturated, and then my lawn's gonna be really uneven. I think I can at least get the front done, so the front will look okay, but the back is what I'm concerned about. I can't believe it's still hailing. Ooh, it's starting to get bigger too.
Look at those pieces of hail right there. Huh. All right, I'm gonna go get my phone.
Well, a new strange quality to this rainstorm has surfaced. It now very, very strongly smells of skunk or sulfur. Yeah. See, that's what I was more concerned about than anything when I was cutting the grass was thunder and the lightning. Not the thunder, I don't care about thunder. It's what accompanies thunder, and that's lightning. It's hailed for kind of a long time. I kind of want to get a picture of it. You know, totally unrelated note, I don't know why people say that the record button is so hard to find on the Sony RX100. I've hit it every time I've reached for it. So, I don't know. Just tweeted a picture of the hail to one of our local meteorologists. My favorite local meteorologist, Nicole Besenzik, is moving. So that sucks. Some of that hail is rolling into the garage. Uncool hail. Uncool. All right, we'll see if I get a tweet back. It's like a celebrity.
Look at that.
It's starting to come into the garage.
You know, the twisted part of me just thought if it's a tornado, at least I'd be recording. I see sweet relief. I'm starting to see light.
TUCat, it rained out my lawn mowing. So this is what I'm up against. Basically, all of these little spots. And I think this is the one that just caused me trouble. And they say up here, hail potential and heavy rain, they were not kidding.
TUCat doesn't seem too bothered by it though. I think it's time to make a sandwich, TUCat.
Just got a text from my mom. This just happened to your house too, so loud, was hitting the back of the house, patio door, even made Polly lose his crap and run in circles. Now, if you remember correctly, Polly is the giant fluffy cat.
Yep, there's their deck. So it came down pretty good over there.
Well, I'm gonna make a sandwich, reply to my mom, and then I guess I'm just hosed on the lawn mowing thing. I might try to finish the front just so it looks symmetrical.
Doesn't get much more generic than that. Turkey sandwich on white. I'm gonna enjoy.
All right, I will not be stopped. I'm going to finish cutting the grass today. I think I have a little bit of a break. I see some dark clouds again to the north and kind of to the west. The other storm passed. I think another one's moving in. We'll see how far I can get this time before it starts to rain and possibly hail again. But I really want to get this done today. I really want to get it done. Especially the backyard, but now it's really gonna be a challenge. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do it. I might have to bail, but we'll see. Well, I'm happy to report lawn mowing was a success. It was a little harrowing there. I had another minute where I had to take a break. Well, it was probably about 10 minutes. Started raining again. I thought maybe I could plow through. I couldn't, so I took a break, let it finish raining, went back out, saw another big dark cloud was floating in. So I rushed to get it done, finished 5 minutes before it started to downpour again. So, got that over with. Feels good. I finally decided on a coffee maker last night. I don't think I mentioned that before. I ended up going with some brand I've never heard of, but it uses K-cups, and it was cheap, and it had really good reviews on Amazon. The only downside was, as they said, it takes about 3 minutes per cup of coffee, whereas I think like a Keurig can do it pretty fast. A Keurig can do it, I think, within like less than a minute. Some people were saying it only takes like 20 seconds for that thing to preheat. But for the price difference, I think I'll wait the extra 2.5 minutes. It's okay. So we'll see. It's supposed to be here today. It said same day delivery. So yeah, we'll see if Amazon pulls that one off. But I'm excited to try it and see how it works because I've been missing my coffee. I need my coffee back.
It's really a depressing day outside. It never got any better. It's down into the mid-50s. But good news, it's perfect weather for coffee. You know what just arrived?
Da, da. That's a bigger box than I anticipated.
This is what the day turned into. Not very appealing. But hey, the grass is cut, and you can really smell it too. Look at the mess I made over here. That is all grass stain. So, whoops. All right, time to bring the package inside. How heavy is this? Oh, it's manageable.
Mr. Gnome. Too many things going on at one time. TV's going to sleep. Chatting on Facebook. I'm editing the vlog. And I'm texting about what Devin and I are gonna do on Friday. She's coming on Friday now. Need to wake up the TV. We need to get some light in here. I'd like to enjoy a little bit of natural light with what's left in the day. Got the backyard cut too. It really is amazing I was able to get that done today because it was a very small window to actually do it, and somehow I pulled it off. Let's do it. I feel like I just did this in the vlog, because I did. As a matter of fact, I just edited that clip of unboxing the S340, so this will likely be the last clip of this vlog. I'm gonna end it on this note. That was a lot of packing. I don't remember ordering this many things. Maybe this coffee. I got like a K-cup sampler. It's pretty substantial. So I think those are both 40 count K-cup variety pack. Oh yeah, I got mugs too. Forgot about the mugs. Look at this light. It's like one color this way, one color this way. It's kind of weird. All right, there are the cups. Pretty classy, pretty classy. I was just enjoying my cup of Joe. Definitely need to wash these out. They stink. This box kind of stinks. My mom said she got a box from Amazon the other day that was kind of smelly. What's going on with the smelly boxes, Amazon? This box doesn't stink because it's got the coffee in it. Caramel drizzle, original. I mean, there's a little bit of everything in here. All right, this I'm gonna have to clean before I use it. So there you have it. Some brand I've never heard of, but I think this should be fine. You just unlock it, you pop this off. This opens up, put the water in, put the K-cup in, pop it down, lock it, you're good to go. So now I can have coffee again, and I've got all those flavors. So I'm pretty pumped about that. I think I'm just going to get, I think that I saw they had like San Francisco Bay was pretty cheap. And, sorry, text message now. Really need to focus. I saw San Francisco Bay, I think was the cheapest bulk K-cups on Amazon. You get like 80 or something crazy for not very much money. So I'll probably go with those. If you do it on a subscription, I think it's $20 or something like that, $20-$25 for 80 cups of coffee. The convenience factor alone makes that pretty cool. So now I've got to clean up the mess I just made and get back to editing the vlog. Also, the battery's almost gone on the camera, so I need to charge it as well. But hey, this was a fun vlog, I think. A lot of different randomness now that I'm actually editing it. A lot of times I get to the like end of the vlog period, and then I'm worried that I didn't have enough things going on. And then I start looking at the clips, and I'm like, it's fine. There's enough in there. It's all good. So I'm going to finish editing that. Good times. As always, if you enjoyed this vlog, please share it with others. Let's get more people in here enjoying this. I'm having a lot of fun. Be sure to join the Facebook group and join that community. It's a really great place to just go back and forth. A lot of the questions I get, a lot of the comments, some of you I actually, you know, go back and forth with in conversations. It's a good place to do that. You can also leave a comment on the video. Of course, you can follow me on my other social media channels like Twitter and Instagram. And of course, on those, I am Tech Uploaded. You can also shoot me an email at techuploaded@gmail.com. And you know the drill. Don't be a stranger. Check back soon.